population of size 10. In easy word, we say there are 10 person in one population, and each person who have 7, we have DNA of length 7. So the DNA has chromosome. This is kind of like a biology algorithm. So we have each chromosome will contain one feature. So for example here, person number 1 has feature 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on. And this will be randomly picked. So we're not going to permute, we're going to randomly pick. And after that, we are going to evaluate each one. So we're just going to feed each person into the machine learning called, we use the model of multiple linear regression model to evaluate as the prediction score. So student, the individual one has the fitness value of 70. Fitness values come from the accuracy of the model. And let's say we have valued all of the individuals, and now we are going to sort those individuals by the fitness function, fitness value. And you can see here at the lower table, as we say that there's a chance of survival. So each individual has the chance of survival. And the best chance of survival has the best score in the fitness value. And we're going to select the best two. Let's say, for example, we have number 7 and number 2, which scores the best of the amongst the generation, amongst the population. And now we're going to see that chromosomes, which is this feature, and now we're going to do crossover. This is a very terminology in biology term. We're going to select the first half from this number 7, and we're going to select the second half from the number 2, and we can have the newborn individual. And each chromosome also has the chance of mutation by, say, mutation where we're going to select the new feature into one of the chromosome. And if the newborn, and then we use multiple linear regression to evaluate the newborn son. And if the newborn has higher score than the previous individual, we're going to replace this one, and we can have the new perfect feature list that evaluated with genetic algorithm. So let's say this is the most appropriate feature list for us, then we're going to feed this feature into the regression model. And now we're going to pass it to Mr. Pilon to explain us about the machine learning model that we're going to select.